Hey guys, so today I'm gonna do a what's on my iPhone XS Max video. Not much different than what I had on my XR, but to start off, I have this wallpaper that I got off Pinterest. I picked it because it has really high image quality resolution. It looks really crisp. And then on the inside, I just have this gold wallpaper to match my gold iPhone, even though it's different shades. But I also wanted a plain background because then you could see my app labels a lot better. So for the home screen, it's pretty basic. Just the calendar app up here just to see the date. And my first folder, which is my everyday folder, my phone calls, my photos, FaceTime, daily horoscope, Safari, shortcuts, iMovie, settings, and music. Then I have my messages app. And then here's my social media, Facebook, Facebook Messenger, Instagram, Twitter, Tumblr, Snapchat, WhatsApp, Pinterest, and YouTube. All my social media is pretty much the same, JG Yvonne. On the second page, I have my app store. You know what that is, download apps, clock, you know what email is, the weather app, Apple Maps, and then I have my photo and video section, which I don't use all of these, but let me see. I pretty much use, these are the ones I use the most. Facetune, I use to make my backgrounds white. VSCO cam, I use this a lot. You can see where I edited from my Instagram. That's probably my favorite one, VSCO cam. PicMonkey I used to use for thumbnails. I haven't used it in a while. Let me see, wait. Afterlight I use here and there. Pretty nice effects on that. HypeType, that's really cool actually. Say I take a picture of the table, let's say. All right, so then you just double tap this. And you could add a... Oops. All right, see it. Check. And then it'll just like. And so, yeah, that's what I use sometimes. Fonto, I use for like my thumbnails. You could just add like font over your picture. Unfold, I like Unfold. It has like nice effects. Snow is also cool. Snow's kind of like, everybody says like Snapchat, but like with more filters. Let's say I use this picture. Hit edit. Go to effects. I usually click on this one. Kind of makes it like VHS or Polaroid, I guess. Yeah, that's pretty cool. InShot is like my favorite one. InShot has like a lot of cool filters. So let's say I chose the same picture. So then I go to like filter, effect, and I can do like some cool like TV thing. My favorite one that I use a lot is glitch. I think that looks mad cool. I just save that. And then I can post it on like my Instagram stories. And then it'll be on my story. What else? Snapseed I use a lot too. That has a lot of like cool tools. Like if you have something in the picture that you don't like, you can just like use the heal tool and like edit it out. This picture of my cat, go to tools, heal. Let's say I didn't want this wire hanging here. You kind of just like make the wire disappear. All right, so anyway, look, I have the picture of him now and the wire is not hanging from the back anymore. A lot of these I haven't really played around with too much or I just didn't like them. But I'll continue to play around with them, update you guys in the future. Google Apps, Gmail, Chrome, Google Duo, which is like FaceTime for you. And let's say somebody doesn't have an iPhone and you want to FaceTime, you can just use Google Duo. It's like similar. Google Photos, Google Assistant, Google Maps, and Voice, Google Voice, which you can get a second number. Shopping, I have Amazon, Amazon Seller, if you want to sell things, eBay, Letgo, and Apple Store. My YouTube sub count. YouTube Studio, let's see. Thanks guys, I appreciate it. I remember when I had like 10. It's always nice to see that grow. I also have the widget on the side. YouTube Studio, which is basically like if you're a YouTuber and you wanna do like quick uploads or edit your videos on the phone. My ride folder, which is Uber and Lyft, that's the only two I use. Food, Starbucks, you have to have Starbucks. Starbucks, necessary. Dunkin' Donuts, kind of necessary. Grubhub, Postmates. I never use Postmates. I don't even know why I have it, but Domino's, DoorDash, Saucy. I never used Saucy either. I think I saw somebody talk about it in a video and I was like, oh, I want to try it. And I never did. Yelp for like reviews and stuff, and Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut and Domino's are my like go-to pizza chains. I don't live in New York anymore, so I can't get real pizza here, but those are pretty good. Finance, you know, money apps, tools, Measure, wallet, Apple Watch, camera, notes, reminders, calculator, Sonic. That's an app, like if you drop your phone in the water, you use that and it expels the water out of your speakers, like with some frequency. Speed test, which I always use to see how fast my network is. Right now it's on Wi-Fi, so this would be my Wi-Fi speeds. Not too bad. Extra stocks. This is stuff that came with the phone pretty much that I don't really use. Boring. Pandora, Shazam, Spotify, SoundCloud, and Amazon Music. I mostly use Apple Music, which is in this folder here. So what else? Keyboards, my Kimoji keyboard, Swift Key, and Gboard. I just leave the regular keyboard. United Airways, Waze, FlightView, and Airbnb. Airbnb is like a must-have. So many good deals, and it's so much better than getting a hotel. You can literally get like an apartment or a house when you're traveling. So much better. Games, I don't really play too many games, but actually, I always find myself coming back to old games like Angry Birds and Plants vs. Zombies. This is nostalgic for me. This is from like my iPhone 4 days. I was obsessed with this game. And then I remember I had this. On my 4 and I was obsessed with it. And then they had it for the PlayStation and it was so much fun. I can't. And then I don't know if anybody ever played this game, but Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare. It's kind of like Call of Duty, but with plants and zombies. It's really freaking awesome. Angry Birds, yeah. Bejeweled, classic, another classic game. All I do is play like old school games. I'm like really boring. You just play classic. Everybody knows how to play these games. There's so many games like this nowadays, but this is like the OG. Let's hear the sounds. Oh. This phone's mad loud. 10S Max. Hello. I kind of suck at these games, but yes. Hey, killed it. All right, let me stop. Emoji Blitz, that's like a Disney game, and it's similar to like Bejeweled, but with Disney emojis. Alien Shooter, this is cool. It's kind of like Galaga. If anybody's like ever played Galaga back in the day. Wait, all right, get out of my face. Let me say day 2, I don't know what this means. No, thank you. So, I don't know, I guess I'm on mission S1, whatever. Okay, let's play 6. Okay, so see, it's like Galaga. And you get like little upgrades to your ship when you kill things. Oh my god, this thing won't die. Ooh, see, I upgraded my ship. You get like different powers, like, or ammo, I guess, different weapons. Ooh. I don't know what this is, but see, like my ammo got like way better, way more powerful. Stronger. All right, that's that. Mario Run is pretty cool, but I prefer to play old school Mario. Fun Run is fun because you get to play with multiplayer, like you can play with other people who have the app. And it's basically like a racing game, kind of like Mario Kart, but a little more graphic because the weapons like kill each other. It's really cool. I have Fun Run 2 and 3. Heads Up. I love Heads Up. Anybody know what Heads Up is? You just put this on your forehead and people give you clues as to, for you to figure out what you are. Like if you're an animal, they have to give you clues, but you can't say like rhymes with or starts with the letter. You kind of just have to give them like clues. Like let's say you're a giraffe. Be like, all right, an animal with a long neck. You know, it's pretty easy. I don't know, but it's fun. I play this at like get-togethers with my family and stuff. Word Connect is fun. I pass a lot of time with this game.
I got a car with an app.
Freaking ads. Nobody cares. So, like, all right, let's say yell is a word, bell is a word, bay. Oh my God, that was a word. Bly? No. Lie? Lay? All right, whatever. I suck at that. What level am I on? I'm on level 193, so I'm doing pretty good, I guess. Beard booth. That was kind of cool to see what I look like with a beard. That's how you can play like old school Pokemon games like Game Boy Advance, all that stuff. It's really good. Asphalt 9 is a cool racing game that I never play either, but I downloaded it because everybody said with the A12 processor, it's supposed to be excellent. I used to love Need for Speed. You could download that actually, I think, here. Need for Speed. Hot Pursuit was my favorite. Let's see, there's a corny car. I'm not gonna play because I suck. Yeah, Silly, Cat Sounds, Strobe Rave, Flashlight. That's like another strobe app. For when I'm playing music and I want to pretend like I'm at a real party. AR apps. I actually just played with this one last night, Magnolia, where you could like. Okay, so like let's say I chose this bag. You see it says preview in your home. You just push this. And then it makes you like find a surface. It's probably hard with this reflection. All right, so let's place it here. Ooh, that's mad big. Anyway, it's on my table. Right, next. Pokemon Go, of course, which I used to be obsessed with. At bat is cool. Like, if you're at a baseball game, you can see like stats of the players, like just by placing your camera over them. Sky view is cool too. I use this all the time at night to see like what planets or stars I can see in the sky. Like, if you're outside, you could see at nighttime. It kind of sucks in the house, but. I'll show, like, I don't know, test it out. Download this app and try it out at night when you're sitting outside. It's freaking awesome. Entertainment, PlayStation apps, E, Watch My Kardashians, MTV, Watch Jersey Shore, Netflix, Prime Video, and Hulu. I've been on Hulu a lot lately watching the show This Is Us, and I'm like mad late to the game, but that show gets me every freaking episode. I'm literally always crying. It's so good, so heartwarming, so emotional. School apps, parks, Disney, Universal, Six Flags. Yeah, that's pretty much all that's on my phone. I haven't really added much else, but if you can see like on my folders, I just spaced out the lettering when I renamed them, so it looks like really nice against the background. And I put everything into folders because I used to have like pages of apps, but it just got annoying. But yeah, that's pretty much what's on my iPhone right now, my XS Max. I gotta play around, add more apps, and take advantage of this beautiful big screen. Of course, I'm always changing my wallpaper, as you guys probably know from my last videos. Pretty organized, pretty neat, looks nice. And I love this big screen. Actually, my hoodie kind of matches. So nice. I love the color. All right, yeah, so sorry guys, that's it. Hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the little bell icon so you know when I post new content. And I will keep you guys posted if I update my iPhone. Bye, thanks for watching.